lights out here in Barcelona for Moto2 in 2022. It's a great start for pole position, bike number 13, Chelsea Vietti. Jake Dixon got away really good as well, a 96 bike from the second row. Likewise, his teammate Albert Reynas on the Gas Gas machine. It looks like it will be Dixon around the outside of Chelsea Vietti in the first corner. Dixon leads.
Goro now does force his way in the battle for Vietti. He's past Celestino Vietti. It is Vietti then coming back at Iagora into turn 10. That's a sweet move from Celestino Vietti.
The Goro tries to get some instant payback on Vietti with some slipstream into the first corner.
Briefly goes through and contact on the way out.
No love lost there between Schrotter and Agüero. He got up the inside of Schrotter and whacked into his side going through turn number 11.
Here's the second round then between Schrotter and Agüero. Schrotter looks like he's made it a bit cleaner that time.
Here comes Dixon, thought about a move on the inside of Kinect going into turn 10. Nobody though, yeah, Kinect just got in a little bit hot. Oh, contact there, clear contact. Kinect was nearly out of the seat there, wasn't he? Dixon then does finally get on through. You can't exactly say it was clean.
Oh, there's someone up in the gravel there. It's Roberts!
Oh, Roberts! No, Joe Roberts is blowing it. Can you believe it? Oh, dear me. Joe Roberts was looking so, so good. He's gone down at turn number 5. He punches the tank in frustration. Roberts was 2.5 seconds clear of the chasing pack. In he goes into turn 5. He's a long, long way round, isn't he? Well into the corner when Joe Roberts loses control of that Kalex machine. Heartache then for Roberts. He's not California dreaming of a second win in Moto2 this year. Down he goes. He's not saving that one. He's going to be bitterly disappointed, bitterly frustrated, so angry with himself. Look at that there. The frustration comes straight out. He slaps the tank in frustration.
We now ride on board then with Augusto Fernandez in fourth position. He's not been able to get close enough for a real attack yet.
Dixon loses third place into turn 12 from Augusto Fernandez. Late drama here in Moto2 on the final lap. Augusto Fernandez with a move on the last lap takes third from Jake Dixon.
That is a good job by Augusto Fernandez, a podium from the third row.
Now
yeah, that was nicely done. He got some slipstream. He just eases on the inside of Jake Dixon. Here comes Vietti. He's leaving that late. It's a late shot on the brakes with Vietti into turn number 10. He got Dixon for second on the previous lap. He now takes over the frontier. Beautifully done by Vietti on the inside of Kinect into turn 10. That's been his preferred overtaking marker in this battle in Barcelona. 5 laps to go here then in Barcelona. And Kinect is trying to find a way back through. He's got some slipstream. Who's going to be latest on the brakes into turn 1? It will be Kinect. He's back at the front.
Well, Vietti was able to brake ever so slightly later, but he couldn't turn in as he now tries to go back on the inside. That's a brave, brave move.
Kinect standing firm in the face of this onslaught. This is a high-pressure situation for Aaron Kinect. Here comes Vietti into turn number 10. That's been where he's been so, so good on the front end of that Kalex machine. And again now, Kinect becomes his latest victim.
You feel the move's going to have to come now for Kinect because we know how good Vietti is into turn 10. Kinect does get at the inside. Vietti won't be able to turn in from there. Kinect put himself in just the right position to force Vietti to give up the lead. Kinect leads at the start of the final lap.
Look at the tight line that Aaron Kinect is running. He's almost on the grass there trying to make sure that there's no way through for Vietti on the brakes into turn 10. Great job by Kinect. He goes a little bit hot. Kinect got in the front. Action hot, the door was open and Vietti does come through. It's a late heartbreak here for Kinect. Late drama here in Moto2 on the final lap. Celestino Vietti, one corner left for him then. The Italian on course for yet another victory here in 2022. I don't think Kinect's going to be close enough. It's going to be a run down to the finish line. It's going to be victory for Vietti in a Moto2 classic here in Barcelona. Celestino Vietti takes it by just 0.08 seconds. Vietti takes 25 precious points, and with Iagüero in 7th, he's wrestled back control of this Moto2 battle in 2022.
Thanks.